สวัสดีค่ะ This video we're gonna learn about buffer solutions. Okay, we start with the question on what is the buffer solution. The answer as shown you here, the buffer solution is the one that can resist changes in pH upon the addition of small amounts of either acid or base. This is thecharacteristic of the buffer solution. It can resist changes in pH, which means the pH of the solution will not change, or it won't change that much when we add some acid or base in a small amount into this solution. Why the solution has this property? Here, the answer isThis is the solution of weak acid in the mixture with its conjugate base. Or we can have buffer solution making from weak base and its conjugate acid. Only this combination, weak acid and its conjugate base, or weak base and its conjugate acid, will produceA solution that can resist changes of pH or buffer solution. These are the two examples of buffer system. On this side is the acetic acid buffer. On this side it is an ammonia buffer. This is weak acid and its conjugate base. This is weak base.And its conjugate acid. This slide is showing you how a buffer works, or another question that we should ask is why buffer can resist changes of the pH. So in this picture, focus on this middle part here first. Buffer consists ofweak acid and its conjugate base. In this example, we have equal concentration of both components. The weak acid, its conjugate base. Look at when we add acid into this buffer solution first, what happened is going to be on this left side. When we add acid, represented here by hydronium ion,What happened, the reaction that happened is down here. The acid that is added will be consumed by the conjugate base, acetate ion. This reaction occurs and it produces weak acid and some water. So here you can see that the amount of acid increased slightly, the amount ofacetate ion or conjugate base decrease slightly. The acid that is added is consumed or used in this reaction. How about we add base to this buffer solution? Adding base represented by hydroxide ion. What happened is this amount of base would be consumed or used by this reaction. Acidreacts with base. Acid react with base, produce conjugate base and water. So on this side, when we add base to the buffer solution, the amount of conjugate base increase slightly. The amount of weak acid decrease slightly. In both things that going on here, adding acid or adding base. The acid that is added or base that is added are consumed. Therefore, the amount of hydronium ion in solution doesn't change. The amount of hydroxide ion in solution also doesn't change. Remember, pH is negative log of hydronium ion concentration.So if this doesn't change, so pH is not changing either. So adding small amount of acid or base doesn't change hydronium ion concentration of the solution. Again, repeat from what I said in the previous slide. For any weak acid and its conjugate base buffer, when we add small amount of acid, this is the reaction that occurs. The added acid is consumed by the conjugate base. If we add small amount of base, this is the reaction that occurs. The base that is added is consumed by the weak acid. These two are buffer components. So in the buffer, which by definition is consists of weak acid and its conjugate base, right? As long as you have this in your solution, you can add acid in and it will be consumed. You can add base in and it will be consumed, right? So concentration of hydronium ion will not change. Concentration of hydroxide ion will not change. The pH will remain almost unchanged. If we try to look at the pH of buffer solution, how it can resist changes of pH upon adding acid or base. Look at the buffer solution of acetate ion and acetic acid. This is the equilibrium weak acid conjugate base. Ka of this equilibrium can be written as concentration of product divided by reactant. Rearrange this Ka equation to find out the concentration of hydronium ion would be equal to Ka times this ratio of acid concentration and conjugate base concentration. From the slide, when we see how the acid and base are added to the solution of buffer, the added hydronium ion or hydroxide ion are consumed, right? So the ratio of this concentration change slightly, very little change. So we say it's almost constant, right? Which means that concentration of hydronium ion here calculated by a constant Ka times this ratio. This concentration is also almost constant, which in turn pH that is calculated from negative log of hydronium ion concentration is gonna be almost unchanged until the amount of added acid or base is a lot, so that there is no acid to react to base, or there is no conjugate base to react to the acid. The concentration of hydronium ion will change a lot, which means the pH will change a lot. Right now, look at this. Once this ratio remains almost constant, the pH will also almost constant. I have video for you here to compare the value here of the pH. In this beaker, this is the solution of buffer solution. In this video, the hydrochloric acid is added into this solution. You have to watch this screen, how the pH value change. Start from 4.6. Here it is. Drop by drop, adding hydrochloric acid in drop by drop. pH remains around 4.6. Quite a bit of hydrochloric acid has been added already. The pH value change, นะคะ it change but doesn't change that much. And we add acid into the solution. Of course, the pH gonna be decreased. But from 4.6 and it's still 4.56, so it's around 4.6 anyway. And quite a bit of the hydrochloric acid has been added, นะคะHow much can you keep adding the acid until the pH change so much more than this? It depends on what we call the buffer capacity. นะคะ However, watch this first. Compare to the weak acid solution. In the beaker here, now it's not buffer solution. It's just the weak.Acid solution, adding hydrochloric acid as well to compare to the buffer solution before. Now let's see how the pH change. This is the pH of weak acid solution. Start around 2.8, นะคะ. When we add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 drops, only 5 drops, the pH drop.By 2.8 to 2.6.5 already. So it proved that buffer solution can resist changing of pH value when we add acid to it. Okay. Same thing can occur when you add base.To the solution. Again, นะคะ adding small amount of acid and base does not change concentration of hydronium ion. Since pH is a negative log concentration hydronium ion, if this doesn't change, then the pH is almost unchanged. However, there's gonna be a limit.In which buffer can withstand the change of pH. You cannot keep adding acid forever. When the maximum amount of acid is added, or when we reach the buffer capacity, the pH will change. Buffer capacity depends on what? Depends on the amount of acid and conjugate base in the solution.Once again, we will look at the equilibrium of buffer solution. Example of acetate, acetic acid buffer, นะคะ. This is the hydronium ion concentration. It's equal to Ka times the ratio of acid concentration and conjugate base concentration, นะคะ. And Henderson-Hasenbalch equation that take negative log.Upon this equation is given here, pH negative log of hydronium ion is pH, negative log of Ka is pKa, and we take negative log of this ratio, change the sign, it's gonna be plus log of concentration of conjugate base divided by concentration of acid, นะคะ. The key in whichThe pH will remain constant, as I told you earlier, is this ratio, right? This ratio. As long as this ratio doesn't change much, the pH will not change much. นะคะ? So this is the important equation to calculate the pH of buffer solution. And we talked about buffer capacity earlier. Buffer capacity, in general, we can get the maximum buffer capacity when the ratio here นะคะ is approximate to 1. It's approximate to 1, which means that the concentration of conjugate base and weak acid concentration is equal. This ratio is 1. นะคะ And the concentration of each item นะคะ should be high enough, should be high enough so that you have quite a lot of this species to consume the added acid or added base. นะคะ And why is it should be 1? Because if you take log of this ratio, log 1 is 0, right? So which means that the pH will always equal to the pKa. นะคะ And it is found that the ratio of this concentration should be within about a factor of 10 to one another. So it's going to be between 0.1 and 10. Okay, 0.1 and 10. If you take log of this ratio, the value should be between minus 1 and 1. This should keep the good buffer capacity of the buffer system. And the buffer solution will have effective pH range around 2 units of pKa. From previous slide, นะคะ, if the log of the ratio is minus 1, your pH gonna be Ka minus 1, right? pKa minus 1, sorry. If the log of the ratio is 1, the pH gonna be pKa plus 1. So this is the effective pH range of buffer. So for example, if we have acetic acid acetate ion buffer, pKa of acetic acid is 4.74. The effective pH range of this buffer gonna be around 3.74 to 5.74. Same thing for ammonium ion buffer. pKa of ammonium ion is 9.26. The effective pH range is gonna be from 8 to 10, นะคะ, like this. Here are the summary of this video. We learn about buffer solution. By definition, it is a solution that can resist changes in pH. The reason why it can resist changes in pH because it's made of weak acid and its conjugate base, or it can be made of weak base and its conjugate acid. Because we have the two components in the buffer to consume or to react to the added acid or the added base that make the concentration of hydronium ion in the solution keep it almost constant. In turn, we're gonna get the pH that is almost constant as well. But the buffer solution has a limit on how much it can take the acid or base that added into it. The limit that the buffer can withstand the change of pH, we call that as buffer capacity. And for buffer, this is the important equation, นะคะ, the Henderson-Hasenbalch equation. Calculate pH from the pKa of the weak acid plus log of the ratio of conjugate base and weak acid itself. So that's it for this video, นะคะ. I see you next time. สวัสดีค่ะ.